Good morning, all of you. Today's session is for class 7 and the chapter name is Colligative Properties. It is present in the page number C3. Now, coming to the introduction part of colligative properties. Generally, physical and chemical properties of aqueous solution. Physical and chemical properties of aqueous solution depending upon nature of solute particle and structure of solute particle. But some properties that are depending upon only upon the number of particles of solute, that properties are known as colligative properties. Irrespective of nature of solute particle, and it depends only upon the number of solute particles. Then that properties are known as colligative properties. Now, how the colligative properties are classified based upon the properties? They are classified totally into 4 types. Those are RNVP, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Coming to depression of freezing point. And elevation of boiling point, and last one, that is osmotic pressure of solution. Now coming to the first colligative property, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now, first one, relative lowering of vapor pressure, RNVP abbreviation, given as follows. Now, coming to the definition, when a non-volatile solute, is added to the volatile solvent, now here B represents solute and A represents solvent. While adding the solute into the solvent, there will be decreasing of vapor pressure of solvent in a solution. Now, it is due to the decreasing of surface area, increasing of density, and moreover here, rate of evaporation also gradually decreases. While adding a non-volatile solute into the volatile solvent, then it causes the decreasing of vapor pressure, increasing of density, decreasing surface area, and the rate of evaporation also gradually decreases. While taking a beaker with some solution, the solution is a combination of solute and solvent. Hence, it is a binary solution. The binary solution, while gaining some energy, the molecules may set into evaporation. Now, the molecules of vapor, the molecules of liquid may get equilibrium condition. Vapor pressure of figure A represents open condition, figure B represents closure condition. In closure condition, the molecules of vapor are setting in equilibrium condition with the molecules of liquid. Nothing but vapor pressure of a solution is equal to atmospheric pressure. Hence, it is an equilibrium condition. Now, what is the lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure represented by delta P. Delta P equal to P naught minus P A. Delta P equal to P naught minus P A. What is called delta P? Lowering of vapor pressure. Delta P represents lowering of vapor pressure. Now, relative lowering of vapor pressure is given as a ratio of change in pressure to the P naught. Change in pressure to the P naught. P naught represents here vapor pressure of pure solvent. Therefore, that equal to P naught minus P A by P naught. P naught minus P A by P naught. Now, the ratio given as relative lowering of vapor pressure. In a binary solution, the solvent represented by B and a solute represented by A. The sum of mole fractions generally represented by the symbol psi. Mole fractions generally represented by the symbol psi. Psi A plus Psi B is always equal to 1. Therefore, the mole fraction of solvent equal to P A by P naught of A. Now, while subtracting each side from the 1 minus P A by P naught of A equal to 1 minus Chi A. Now, while simplifying the given equation, P naught of A minus P A by P naught of A equal to 1 minus Chi A. 1 minus Chi A we are getting from the above equation, that is Chi B equal to 1 minus Chi A. Chi B equal to 1 minus Chi A. Therefore, we can write here Chi B. Now, as earlier we discussed that one, B represents for solute and A represents for solvent. The mass of a solute represented by small m and W represents the mass of solute. Small W represents mass of solute and small m represents a gram molecular mass of solute, and capital M represents molecular weight of solvent, and capital W represents here weight of solvent. Therefore, we can write here number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. For a dilute solution, number of moles of solute very less than number of moles of solvent. Therefore, the above equation becomes P naught of A minus P A by P naught of A equal to NB by N. Now, as earlier we discussed that one, NB represents number of moles of solvent, that is given weight by gram molecular weight of given substance by capital W by capital M. Therefore, while simplifying the above equation, we will get the delta P by P naught of A equal to small w into capital M by capital W into small m. Small m represents molecular weight of solute. Capital M represents molecular weight of solvent. And capital W represents weight of solvent. Now, from the above equation, we can write small m equal to small w nothing but weight of solute into capital M molecular weight of solvent by capital W weight of solvent into delta P by P naught of A. Nothing but we can write here P naught of A. From the above equation, nothing but molecular weight of solute can be calculated from the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now in this session we discussed the one of the first colligative property, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. In next class we will continue the one more colligative property. Thanks for watching.